back. I'm so excited for today's episode. I'm going to talk to you about how to connect your brand to your audience, and I've got two really easy tips for you. Let's dive in. That might be new here. My name is Michelle Knight, and I am the founder of BrandMary.com. I'm a branding and business coach, and I work with female entrepreneurs to tap into their story to create a standout brand that gives them the time, financial, and location freedom that they desire. Something I'm really good at is identifying the brand story in female entrepreneurs. And what I've been hearing a lot from my community is, okay, well, once I identify that brand story, how do I then connect my brand to my audience? So today I wanted to talk to you about two simple steps that need to happen in order to do that. I love simple, so let's break this down, shall we? Number one is you've really got to feel rooted and grounded in your story. And I love to actually give my brand story kind of a persona, right? And for a lot of us, it's us. We are a brand. But if for some reason you don't have a personal brand and you stumbled upon this channel, then go ahead and give your brand a personality. I'm gonna use my brand as an example. I'm gonna use me as an example because it's easiest. So for my brand, I really love to identify the purpose, the mission, what are the values of my brand. And so I know that my brand values freedom. Duh. Freedom, right? I value authenticity. I value honesty. I value transparency. Those are some of the core values of myself and of my brand, and I love to get that through in everything that I do in my business. Now, the purpose of my brand is to really empower women to share their story through authentic branding, to show up as they are and share their voice, their message with those that need to hear it most. And then we could say that my mission is really, again, to not only empower women to uncover their story, but also own their story so that we can create a ripple effect of women just owning their shit and getting shit done. So that's really my brand. And you can see that when you give those pieces, the values, the purpose, the mission, your brand becomes so much more. And that's what I really want you to take away from anything I talk about in regards to branding. Your brand should be so much more than just what we typically think about when we think about branding, right? Logo, color, font. So number one is to really identify the values, your purpose, the mission, any other key pieces that you want to throw in there as well, so you feel really solid in who your brand is. Not just what, but who your brand is. Now the second piece of the puzzle, because we're talking about how do we connect our brand to our audience. So the second piece of the puzzle is knowing your audience. You can't begin to connect with your audience if you don't actually know what your audience values, what your audience is struggling with, what your audience is really looking for, what inspires your audience. These are all really important pieces and honestly allow you to not only connect your brand, but to come up with amazing content effortlessly as well. So you want to start thinking about your audience at this point in time. Once you feel rooted in your brand, and a piece of the branding process is definitely market research. You'll probably hear me talk about that a ton. I love market research. After, of course, you've looked inward, then it's time to kind of look outward and do the market research. But after you've done that, it's about really identifying what your audience needs in this moment. So what are they struggling with? What pieces of your story will connect with your audience? And it's not always everything in that moment. When I started my business, I shared very little about the birth of my son. I talked a lot about struggling with my 9-to-5, right? I talked about my son being present, but I didn't necessarily go into all the details of vulnerability and the mindset and all of that stuff because it just didn't resonate with my audience at the time. But as my audience has grown and how my mission has grown, now I openly talk about vulnerability and dealing with perfectionism and how that resulted in an 80-hour labor. Yes, an 80-hour labor. So you can see that this is going to change. So it's not saying that like you can't share every piece of your story, but it's identifying which pieces to share in that moment, how best to connect with your audience, how best to inspire them to take action. Because no matter what it is that you have a business around, whether it's health and wellness, life coaching, business coaching, branding, maybe you're an accountant, maybe you're in a marketing, you're a virtual assistant, it doesn't matter. You really want to be able to connect with your audience, and ultimately you want your audience to take action. So that's really the key piece. It's not only identifying your story, but giving your brand an identity, and then knowing what pieces to connect with your audience in those moments. And I love to ask my audience, I'm constantly doing market research, I'm constantly asking my audience, hey, what do you need on this topic? So don't be afraid to ask. You will be surprised how much amazing content you can get from your audience, which will only allow you to better connect your brand to what they really need most, and in result, they will take action. Okay, that's it for today's episode. A big piece of what I teach is all about story work. And so every quarter of 2018, I'm going to be hosting my signature challenge on how to own and uncover your story for a bold, captivating, and money-making brand. If for some reason you missed the recent one, you can always go ahead and sign up ahead of time and you'll receive notifications so you can save your spot. Just go to brandmary.com/brandchallenge. More information is below for you as well. And I have a couple free gifts for you. Just check the description below. As always, leave a comment if this resonated with you. Check me out on Facebook, Instagram, and join my private community, Authentic Brand Builders. Just go to authenticbrandbuilders.com. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you all again soon.